5, new video of a Kenosha man getting arrested. He's accused of killing his girlfriend before holding police at a standoff for hours. As Colleen Henry reports tonight, neighbors were caught in the middle of the tactical situation that ended a volatile relationship.
For 10 hours, Kenosha tactical teams surrounded the home of a suspected killer who ignored their coaxing till an explosive finale.
As police shut down the neighborhood and ordered people to their homes, some grabbed their cameras to document the tactical situation.
Yesterday is a hard day.
Yayo was home with his 3 kids Wednesday and grabbed his camera when he saw the SWAT team outside.
When the tactical people moved, I got a video. When somebody's moving, I got the video.
He posted highlights on Facebook. The robot removing a window from the home where the suspect holed up. The explosion that blew out the front door so tactical officers could enter.
When exploding the bomb, that's scary.
Finally, the SWAT team hauling away their suspect. That's when reality set in. Police found 33-year-old Heather Adamski dead in the basement, a single gunshot to the head.
It's sad. It's sad.
Mary Yanez has known the suspect for decades, but just met Adamski when the couple moved in across the street last year. It was a tough relationship.
She's jumped out of the window more than once running from him. He goes to jail and she'll go back to him. So we tend to mind our own business sometimes. And then yesterday after everything happened, we all just started crying because maybe sometimes we shouldn't mind our own business or she'd still be around.
In Kenosha, Colleen Henry, WISN 12 News.
Kenosha police say they continue to investigate this. The suspect remains in custody on a probation hold, and his criminal record dates back to the 1990s.
Well, a coast